What's up, everybody? It's your girl, Danny, with Danny Girl Comics, and I'd like to welcome you to the Department of Comics FOC Hot Picks. If you are new to our channel, thank you for checking us out. And for those who have stuck with us through our hiatus, thank you for your continued support. I am happy to present these fire picks courtesy of our awesome Discord member, Omega Taz. If you enjoy the content, be sure to like this video, subscribe to the channel, and ring that notification bell. And if you don't do any of that, we appreciate you watching just the same. And now, it's about that time. Let's get into our picks. Kicking off the list with Marvel Comics, we have Dark Ages number one. We have a new series that brings all of our heroes together against an unknown threat. We know that this will change everything. We have this one as a must-buy and read series as we will see our heroes become something new. This first issue has some cool covers, so be sure to pick up the ones that you like. Next, we have Ultimate Fallout 4 Facsimile Edition. Facsimiles don't normally have huge resale value, but they are nice to display if you don't want to display your original or if you don't own a copy. Many resell for about $10 to $20, but with the popularity of Miles Morales, we could possibly see higher resale amounts for a facsimile, and that's just something for you to keep in mind. Our next book comes from Fantagraphics, Red Room number one, second printing. When this title released, there was so much hype for it and sales showed a demand for it. Now value has lowered mostly for cover A and can easily be found for cover price. The ratios for the most part have kept their value. Due to the hype slowing down on this title, however, this could lead to the second print being an underordered comic. So you may just want to pick up a copy. We have a couple of books on our list from Black Mass Studios, starting with White number one, third printing. The hardest and therefore more valuable print for this title is the first print, but we suggest not dismissing the prints that follow. White is riding on the success of the comic Black, and if the rumors of Warner Brothers planning something are true, White could also benefit from this and see an increase in value. This would be a long hold if you're willing. We also have White number two, second printing. Just as we mentioned before, with the third print of issue one, these reprints could be something to get. I've already pre-ordered my copy, and this is the cover that was loaded at the time of my pre-order. The last book on our list comes from Aftershock Comics, Kaiju Score number one, third printing. This third print is being released 9 months after the first print was released, and this was brought due to the hype of this series being adapted for Sony. How this print will do is still up in the air, as the first print is selling for around $10 to $15 now on the secondary market. The second print seems to be a really low print run, and if you are investing in this series, then that would be the print to get. Not many copies of this second print are for sale, but sales have been in the $30 to $40 range. That's our picks for you this week. The books on this list have a final order cutoff date of August 9th. All the books on this list can be purchased through the Comic Corner, which is a partner store through the Department of Comics Discord. We want to make sure that we show the Comic Corner our support, so make sure you get those FOC orders in. We'd also like to invite you to follow the Department of Comics on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. And you can also find me, Danny, at Danny Girl Comics on Instagram, as well as Danny Girl Comics on YouTube. We will provide all the links in the description below so that you can easily follow all of our social media. Now, with that being said, we want you to remember that the books on this list are the books that we at the Department of Comics have our eyes on, But we always want you to remember to buy what you like, and happy hunting.